Well, I think with respect, the club is responding to the issues that have been raised, and indeed the recent development of the main stand helped to address those issues in terms of creating rail, fan parks, places for people to congregate around the stadium as opposed to actually in the residential streets. I refer to the fact that the club is looking at the litter picking, for the solutions within the area to actually additional stewards to actually address that sort of issue. So, with respect, they are being addressed, but I think, as Mr. Hayes says, there are certain things that are a consequence of ongoing management around the stadium, and others that are planning issues as well. So, there are planning issues that can be controlled, and then there's an ongoing management, and sometimes that is responding to issues as they arise in terms of how the club is actually working with the community and working with local people who actually come to the stadium.
So why do people still raise these issues, I believe, as we have done today?
Thank you, Sam, for coming forward again. I want to hand over to our planning officer to go on to agenda item 6, then I propose that we will vote on them separately. And I would like the issue of the transport plan. From our point of view as a council, do we think that there's going to be any further improvement? Because obviously things are not working well at the moment.
Yeah, just for my clarification, you're proposing for me to go through item number 6 in relation to concerts, and then you will take a decision on both thereafter. Okay. Again, you've got a very detailed report. Clearly the issues are perhaps more substantial in relation to this particular application, given that they are intended, that the proposal is intended to operate specifically during the period as outlined in the presentation and as in your notes, for that period, the end of May to the end of, beginning of May, middle of May to the end of June. And it obviously raises issues, not just about the matters that have been highlighted in relation to the previous item, but also because the activity will be taking place during the evenings as well, and the noise from the concert is obviously a very important consideration as well. So, Chair, again, the principle of development is not dissimilar to the previous item. We've gone through that in the report. Again, in terms of transport and traffic matters, in relation to this particular application, they have, the applicants submitted a framework events transport strategy, which, as the report points out, is informed by the current Anfield Stadium matchday transport strategy, and as it says there, was put into place as part of the stadium expansion, and the applicant again has commented about that. In relation to this particular proposal, for each event, there will be a detailed transport management plan produced as part of that overall event management plan that's required for licensing, and that will set out how traffic and transport will operate for each specific event. That has been looked at, so those matters that have been outlined in the framework documents submitted as part of the application have been looked at very carefully by highway colleagues, and again their comments are set out in full on pages 67, 68 and 69 of your agenda papers, and they conclude that subject to those measures and appropriate conditions being attached to any permission, they will be sufficient to control and manage and mitigate the effects of additional activity arising from concerts or sporting events. Again, your head of planning has concluded that subject to those measures, that is a satisfactory way forward. There will be some amendments required to the traffic regulation order as necessary, but again, subject to those various matters that are outlined in the report that satisfy that the impact in terms of traffic and transport can be managed appropriately. Likewise, in terms of residential amenities, a lot of the concerns that have been raised in relation to the first item also apply to this item. It's about the comings and goings of people to the event, the behaviour of some of those people, the impact on alcohol, based on that report that the impact would be negligible, or would not be significant, rather, in relation to the impact on nearby residents. There's also been a specialist technical noise report submitted with the application, which again has been carefully considered by environmental health colleagues, who again are satisfied with the conclusions, but made some specific recommendations around controlling the hours of operation of any events and the maximum noise level at any noise sensitive premises around the site. And again, that's set out on page 72 of your papers. In relation to air quality, again, that's a point that was raised from the speakers. And again, that has been considered through the application process. The technical note was submitted, again, to be looked at by your officers. And again, we're satisfied that that can be adequately dealt with. In terms of the other issues, again, Chair, we've had regard to all the representations that have been made in writing. We've had regard to the policies of the development plan, the objections that have been raised, other material considerations. And the head of our planning's conclusion is that, again, this is a development that can be supported by you as a planning committee, subject to detailed conditions around event management, and subject to changes to the legal agreement that was attached to the original permission. Again, Chair, the issues aren't complicated in planning terms. They are something for you as a planning committee to take into account against that balance between the economic benefits that might accrue together with the concerns that you've highlighted this morning. Again, I'm happy to answer any specific questions, Chair.
Are there any questions from the officer? It does seem to me that we've got very high levels of concern and distress from the residents expressed here today. So that's why I want to consider the two items separately, because agenda item 5 is to extend the types of sporting event that we have at Anfield. And this has got historical precedence. So I would like to move that agenda item 5 be approved. Is that agreed?
Sorry, can I move that the application is rejected based on what we've witnessed here today, based on the fact that the applicant has not addressed the issues that residents have raised, and also the lack of infrastructure around the area, and also regards to noise pollution too?
Councillor Doyle, do you want some assistance in terms of wording for that? And to paraphrase somewhat, the reason for refusing your stating will be harmful to residential amenity, and results in excessive levels of noise and disruption to local residents, and have a harmful impact on the local highway network. Is that correct? Is that seconded by the name? Thank you, Councillor Flores. We will deal then with Councillor Doyle's amendment, which effectively to refuse the first application, number 5, additional supporting events. All those in favour of refusing the application and supporting this motion, please raise your hand. Lily? That's 4. All those against? 3. Councillor Doyle's motion is carried and the application in respect of item 5 is refused. Chair?
So I'd now like to go on to consider agenda item 6, which would be the matter of extending the season as well as having music events here. And I would like to propose that this item gets deferred to another planning committee, because we need a lot more information about what's going on about the noise and about the way that Liverpool Football Club are going to address the issues that have been raised here today that we couldn't foresee. They weren't part of our notes. And we have to have a satisfactory answer from Liverpool Football Club before I think we can sensibly consider this. We've been told about what goes on in Southampton and the Etihad Stadium. But Anfield does seem to me to be a very different place within a densely built area of the city. So I would like more information. I would like to recommend that we defer item 6. Is that agreed?
Just for purposes of clarity, by your presence, the fact that this now is with the bigger committee, that item number 6 is deferred and will go forward to committee A after the committee.